Hello, my name is Marco Antonio Valladares from Universidad Mariano Galvez de Guatemala, and today I'll be talking about the origin of processions for another installment of tiny lecture series for Archaeology Now. Guatemala should be recognized for its syncretism. Almost 5 centuries ago, Mayan and European people collided but produced singular and unique cultural manifestations in the world. One of these with great presence and force in society are processions. During the colony, there was a school of imagery that carving wood the best sculptures of Nazarenes of the 17th century in the world. I would dare to say, they became the center of the procession for their realness, beauty, expressiveness, for achieving the impression of Jesus of Nazareth alive walking through the street with the cross on his back. Images have accompanied Christianity since its origins. Meanwhile, Mayan people, like all ancient civilizations, used to have physical representations of their gods, the idols. They had no problem with seeing their images, rather, it was necessary to do so. During the colony, the Spanish had difficulty trying to suppress idolatry, so one of the steps the church took was to create its own imagery. Then the altars began to be filled with the sculptures of Jesus, the Virgin Mary, the apostles, the saints, and other sacred figures. Almost immediately, they were used for processions. Despite their differences, both Mayans and Spanish found a point in which they agree: love for processions. The impact was so great that over the centuries the practice grew. The largest processional leaders in the world are in Guatemala. These are 17 meters or larger. Two of them are a Guinness record. The processional leaders started out being very small, carried by 8 or 10 people more than 4 centuries ago, at least here in Guatemala. Every season, there were more people who wanted to carry their sacred images. Then, in the beginning of the 20th century, the leaders began to grow to 20 people, to 40 people, to 80 people, and so go on. It was the signal of the increasing of the practice. Now, the standard of a big leader in a big procession is 120 people. 60 each side of the leader. The largest one is found in El Calvario Church, is carried by 140 people, has about 25 meters long, and you can see it on Holy Friday in the streets with the sculpture of Jesus Christ dead, Cristo Yacente, as we call him. Between 8 to 17,000 people come together as part of a brotherhood, cofradía, or association for 12 or 18 hours to complete the routes, which are seen by many thousands more in Guatemala City, Antigua Guatemala, which is a World Heritage Site, and throughout the nation during Lent and Eastern Week, or Holy Week as we call. It is the cohesive element of the society. All strata attend to the processions. Guatemala loves Eastern because it makes us activate all the senses almost simultaneously. The carpets on which the processions walk are a visual gift. They are made of fresh leaves, vegetables, and highly aromatic flowers and fruits, such as pine, sawdust, and corozo. The funeral marches which accompany the processions, like what we are hearing in the background, are love for all who attend the processions. They are melancholic composition of beautiful melodies that touch the spirit. Everyone in Guatemala has the opportunity to exercise touch because they can participate in the making of the allegories, the altars and gardens, the embroidery, the rugs in the streets, almost anything they want. And as if that weren't enough, we have a varied range of culinary delicacies that we all eat these days, like the curtido, various fish recipes, the little travel tamales, the torrejas, the molletes, and the empanadas of dulce de leche. They are dishes that are enjoyed in the company of friends and family, and that taste like Eastern, as the corozo smell like these days too. But when did they start? There are historical records of Catholic processions over 400 years old, and there is much more of it. As you can see, these are just two of several Mayan ceremonial ceramic vessels from the 7th century AD, from the late classic period, showing ancient processions. In them, you can see the leaders, the idols, the porters, the wind and percussion music band, dressed up even with their dogs, as happens in Guatemala City in the present. We have evidence that this happened from the late pre-classic period, 200 BC. We are talking about a practice that is more than 2,000 years old. The last 2 years, the practice has been suspended due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Although this year there were some intramural practices to keep faith and hope alive, following the proper rules and hygiene and social distancing. The procession have not disappeared, and once the pandemic is controlled, they will resurface with greater force because people miss them and need them. This was Marco Antonio Valladares for Archaeology Now.